Good morning, class 11th, Bala children. Today we will discuss about the excretory system of human being, and main topic for that excretory system, it is formation of urine. So as children you know that kidney is made up of nephron, all things are over. Then this nephron have glomerulus, Bowman's capsule, all they both together form the Malpighian body. Then proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubule, and in between there is loop of Henle. After that DCT, there is collecting duct, and this collecting duct will collect the urine and then it will send it to the pelvis, and through the pelvis it will go to ureter, and ureter will send it to the urinary bladder. Okay, now today I will discuss, or we will study about the formation of urine. So formation of urine, it takes place with the help of three steps. First step, glomerular filtration, that means filtration takes place with the help of glomerulus, that is the efferent arteriole, whatever it carries the unfiltered blood along with the urea and some excretory products. So all will be filtered, and that filtration is called as glomerular filtration because it occurs in the glomerulus, in the Bowman's capsule. Next one, reabsorption, and third one, tubular secretion. So children, glomerular filtration, yet it is arteriole, so the lumen or the cavity will be very less rather than the artery, so it will create some pressure, and while going with the efferent arteriole is having less diameter rather than the efferent arteriole, so it also creates a high hydrostatic pressure. So filtration takes place with these two effective measures. One is effective filtration pressure, that means the pressure which affect the filtration, that is effective filtration pressure, which is hydrostatic. It means the pressure is present due to the presence of fluid, and which helps to filter the blood. Next to it, depends on the permeability of the membrane. That means the membrane should be permeable to filter the material through it. And this permeability always is very effective, or always be efficient with the help of some minerals. If the cells of this Bowman's capsule or glomerulus do not have this mineral in them, so their permeability become less. Yet pressure is there, but rate of filtration will be less. So that's why on these two things our glomerular filtration will depend. First is effective filtration pressure, second is permeability of the membrane. Now reabsorption, name as suggested you, reabsorption, it means absorption done by again and again, that is called as reabsorption. So children, reabsorption can take place by the two processes, active and passive. Children, active process, if it is there, it means the presence of material, whatever is dissolved already in the plasma, it can be taken very easily by the blood, or it can go very easily to the peritubular capillary, just like glucose, amino acid, any molecules which are soluble in plasma. So it can go along with the plasma, it can go very easily to the blood capillary. So that's why it is called as active reabsorption. Now children, we will go to the passive reabsorption. As children, you know, passive reabsorption means it simply you call just like the diffusion. So according to the diffusion children, diffusion always needs some concentration gradient. According to the concentration gradient, diffusion will go down. So in the passive reabsorption, so one side there will be the high concentration and another side there will be the low concentration. So this is present in the high concentration, that urea, creatinine, ammonia, ketone bodies, etc. All these are taken by the blood because of that high concentration. Yet it is not important for our body, but also they mix with the blood by the passive reabsorption. So it will reabsorption because reabsorption is necessary for the important material, not for the other thing. So again these materials have to secrete while the formation of the urine when it takes place, or it is going on, formation is going on. So third step is tubular secretion. So children, tubular secretion, it means that some things are given to the urine and then our formation of urine will be completed. Those who are not important for us, for our body, or those who have to excrete it out, all these things again will be secreted to the tubule for the formation of blood. So reabsorption, suppose just now we are coming for the reabsorption, that is in a PCT, loop of Henle and DCT. So this is by PCT. These things are reabsorbed here children. Sodium ion, potassium ion, glucose molecule, amino acid, chloride ion and bicarbonate ion. See children, there are two positive ions and two negative ions. Then only they can maintain the ionic balance. So this is done by the PCT. And at the end of the PCT, there will be the secretion of few things which are not necessary for our body. See, just like creatinine, then ammonia, iron and urea. These are, yet they are reabsorbed by the passive reabsorption. But now PCT will do some important thing for absorption to for our body, and some not important, unimportant things they again start to secrete out. So at the end of the PCT, it will secrete creatinine, ammonium ion and urea. Now by the loop of Henle, now second part of the tubule is the loop of Henle. So by the loop of Henle, more amount of water will be absorbed. PCT also will absorb water and loop of Henle also absorb water. Then sodium ion and potassium ion and chloride ion. And again at the end of the loop of Henle, it again also secrete out some amount of urea, some amount of ammonium ion. So ionic balance will be there. So one positive ion will goes outside, and along with that some potassium also ion also they secrete it out. They keep in the tubule or in that blood sodium ion and chloride ion. Now by DCT, DCT again remaining water it will absorb whatever our body needs for our blood concentration of the blood, to maintain the concentration of the blood. So that much water again taken by the DCT, then sodium ion also, potassium ion also, they will reabsorb it. and after the absorption, to maintain ionic balance, again it will secrete potassium ion. So children, in this way our urine can form in a proper way, and all the materials which should be passed from our body, then they can secrete up to the last part of the DCT, and then there will be the formation of urine takes place. Okay children, now I will tell you some words by which it can be measured, or suppose you can calculate about the measurement of urine, how much it is forming in your body. Okay, now before that we will go for the ornithine cycle. Yes, ornithine cycle is very important for the formation of urine. So children, first there is the, suppose whatever we are eating, from everything some undigested material will be there, and they will be secreted out from our body through the, or with the help of feces. But when there will be the protein diet, so after deamination of the protein, it will form that ammonia. This ammonia along with the citrulline is the enzyme or material which is present in our body, along with the citrulline, and it excrete out water. This ammonia reacts with the citrulline and release out water, it form arginine. Here it is the one step here, or when deamination of the protein takes place, here there will be the formation of ammonia. Then ammonia along with the carbon dioxide, before the formation of urea, it will form citrulline. Then again citrulline will form the arginine. These two steps, one by one, any one step can go on in a proper way. Either after deamination of a protein, ammonia will form along with the citrulline, will release water, will form the arginine. And if suppose in the another way, deamination of ammonia protein takes place, it will form ammonia. Ammonia along with the carbon dioxide, it is not formed directly, not from the urea. First it will form citrulline. And citrulline again will release water, then it will form arginine. Then arginine will continue some reactions and it will form the next free material, ornithine. So this ornithine, when it will change by releasing water, it will form urea, and this urea is formed in our liver, and this ornithine lastly will be changes into urea. And this urea, when we are releasing it out from the body, it will be in the form of uric acid. So most poisonous, that is, it was ammonia, and after the formation of urea, then urea is a less toxic, even uric acid is more less toxic than the ammonia. So in this way it can be excreted out from our body. So this is known as the ornithine cycle. Yes children, now there are some formula, fractional reabsorption. It is equal to whatever tubular reabsorption we have, divided by, as we have plasma concentration of our blood into glomerular filtration rate. So, what do you understand by fractional reabsorption? Fractional reabsorption, that means what they are reabsorbing throughout the tubule, what type of or what amount of fractions they are absorbing it. So, to get it, we have total tubular reabsorption we should have, then we should have plasma concentration. What is the concentration of our plasma, and then glomerular filtration rate. By calculating these, we can get the fractional reabsorption. So, children, in 24 hours, it is the ratio of our formation of urine, or it will show us the formation of urine in 24 hours. Actually, GFR, it should be 125 milliliter per liter. So, 1 liter of water in 1 minute, 125 milliliter of glomerular filtration should be there. This is the constant value. Now, it depends on your body, how much your body can function, how much it can do its for the formation of the urine, and how much possibilities are there that there will be the formation of urine can take place. And this is also the constant value that for the full day, according to this value, for the full day, it should be 180 liter. In the full day, we have glomerular filtration should be 180 liter. And you can imagine that 180 liter of glomerular filtrate will be concentrated into 1 or 1.5 liters of urine per day. So, children, this much amount of fluid can be fluid along with the minerals can be reabsorbed by our tubule. So, this is a very high range of fluid which should be reabsorbed for our body. If suppose it is not reabsorbed, then our body will lose some material through the urine, or may we can gather, we can collect some extra material which should be excreted out, but it can't. Regular, if it is perfect, then we have no problem for our kidney or no problem for our urine formation. Yes, children. Now, after that, there is dialysis. Dialysis, you know, those patients have fully lost their absorption of kidney. Maybe it is starting, or at the last or the end of the life, they have fully lost their filtration power of their kidney. Then they have to start dialysis. Dialysis is the filtration of urine in or done by the machine. So, that machine is known as dialyzer. Dialyzer have pipe shaped structure or tubular structure. So, through this pipes, it is made up of cellophane paper. Through this pipes, the unfiltered blood can be passed which is taken from our radial artery, and after filtration again it will be sent to our body by the radial vein, and it goes to our heart. After filtration, when it goes to heart, then our heart again pumps for our full body. So dialyzer is the machine which helps to filter the blood. Dear children, you know about the dialyzer. Okay children, then God bless you. And okay, no, some diseases are there which may happen to your or due to the kidney problem. One it is okay, kidney transplantation when can be done because your kidney is lost, and if you can get it, then you can get the new kidney from the other patient, other person, sorry. And then uremia, that means when blood will collect more urea in the blood, that is uremia. Then glomerulonephritis, that means there is the inflammation when there will be the ultrafiltration. So glomerular can't filtrate properly, that is glomerulonephritis. And then children, renal calculi, so there is the problem in the calluses of the kidney. So these are the common diseases which occurs due to the failure of the kidney. Now children, okay, thank you, God bless you.